While Gradle provides a great model for projects, allowing you to define tasks and dependencies between them, by default, an empty build script doesn't do much, or anything really. And this is on by design. Gradle doesn't want to enforce any opinions on how your build should work. In fact, your Gradle build doesn't necessarily have to build anything. Fundamentally, Gradle is an automation tool. So whether it's an Android project, Java project, C++ project, or database migration build, Gradle is there to make cumbersome tasks easy. However, in many cases, our projects will follow some conventions, and those conventions carry over into how we build our project. We want to provide some way to tell Gradle what kind of project we're building and what capabilities we want as part of our build. Just like a big software project is easy to understand when it's broken up into highly cohesive libraries, it also makes sense to factor out build logic into reusable components. With Gradle, we do this through the use of plugins. A good plugin extends the Gradle model to encompass some new domain, providing new tasks, new DSL elements to configure, and sensible default behaviors. A plugin can do anything that can be done in a Gradle build script itself. They can define tasks, configure repositories, or even apply other plugins. Plugins can even extend the Gradle DSL, allowing users to model a specific domain. Later on in this course, we'll learn how the Google Android team has done exactly this to allow developers to describe their Android projects in Gradle build scripts. Next, let's learn where we can find out more about the hundreds of Gradle plugins that are freely available.